Lebih dari 14.000 orang mendatangi Freedom Hall di kota Louisville, negara bagian Kentucky, untuk memberikan penghormatan terakhir bagi petinju legendaris dan aktivis kesetaraan hak Muhammad Ali. Di antaranya ada Muslim Amerika, baik warga Kentucky maupun yang sengaja datang dari berbagai negara bagian lain di Amerika.
He was like this mythological feature in our community, and I met him when I was 10 years old. He came to our mosque in Lexington.
For us, it was just an honor to, you know, plan the trip out and have the time to come out here.
As a child growing up, you have two heroes in your life. One is your dad, and the other is Muhammad Ali.
Selain itu ada warga non-Muslim, termasuk promotor tinju ternama Don King, serta pejuang kesetaraan hak warga berkulit hitam Jesse Jackson.
Sholat jenazah Muhammad Ali merupakan sholat jenazah yang terbesar di Amerika dan dilakukan di Freedom Hall yang merupakan lokasi pertandingan profesional Muhammad Ali yang pertama.
Lincahan dan kekuatannya di ring memang diakui dunia, tetapi kiprahnya di luar arena tinjulah yang ikut diingat, seperti perjuangan almarhum untuk pengakuan minoritas Muslim serta kesetaraan hak warga berkulit hitam.
Beyond the ring, Ali found greatness. He used the exalted position of heavyweight boxing champion, maybe the best boxer of all time in his weight. Yet overcame that rejection without a sense of hate or bitterness. He got better and not bitter. He used that strength of his to fight for peace.
Usai sholat jenazah di Freedom Hall, jenazah Muhammad Ali akan dibawa melintasi Muhammad Ali Boulevard ke rumahnya semasa kecil sebelum dimakamkan. Dari Louisville, negara bagian Kentucky, demikian laporan tim VOA.